Welcome to this week's program of Ascend Life on the Autism Spectrum. I'm Keith Halperin.
And I'm Will Burnick.
Today, our guest is Debbi Siegel, Executive Director of Different Brains, a very prominent South Florida organization for people on the spectrum. But before we begin with, Will, what's your t-shirt this week? We can't see it.
This week's shirt is my new Cal State East Bay sweatshirt. I got it recently from the Cal State East Bay bookstore. I was a student at Cal State East Bay, and I still wear them to continue my pioneer pride. Anyone from Cal State East Bay or Hayward in general should know what pioneer pride represents in Hayward.
Excellent. Thank you, Will. For those of our viewers who may not be familiar with, Cal State University East Bay has a very advanced program designed to help our members on the spectrum. So thank you for bringing that up again, Will. Will, would you like to begin with Debbi now?
Debbi, tell us how you came to be in the autism community.
Hi, I came into the autism community because I have a brother with autism. And when he was born 50 some years ago, they didn't really call it autism. They said he had severe learning disabilities. And as we learned through time, it was called autism. And now, now we have a much better understanding of it. I was able to, being his older sister, teach him to read, teach him to write, things that they said he would never be able to do. He ended up going to a technical school, working in our family business, things that they never said he'd be able to attain. My parents never believed in anything the doctor said about him, and they took him, traveled the world, found everything that they could. And right now he actually is married to someone else with autism, which is beyond our belief. They live next door to her mother, who helps take care of them. And the things he's not good at, she's good at. The things she's not good at, he is. And it's kind of a great story. And they live a great life right now. And it's happy. And I'm proud to work at Different Brains. And that's really how I came to them, because that's my passion in life, is helping support this community.
Debbi, tell us about Different Brains.
So Different Brains is run by Hacky Reitman. He was an orthopedic surgeon, boxer, and also has a daughter who was born with Asperger's and epilepsy, and had many brain tumors. And so he kind of came into this and started Different Brains, looking to help others with the same situation. And he covers a little bit more. He looks at all neurodiversities and likes to help people with any type of brain disorder, from autism to Alzheimer's. And what we find is that a lot of neurodiversities have, like if you have autism, you may have anxiety. If you have autism, you may have depression. So we like to cover a lot of different things. And he gives speaking engagements. And a lot of times people reach out to him and say, how can we find out more? What else can we do? So we run a mentorship program where locally is really how it started, and people would come into the office and we do film editing, we do recording. We do podcasts, webcasts that all go on our website. And it's all run by our interns. And since the coronavirus happened, I think I might answer two questions here, but since the coronavirus happened, it has sprung into this national internship program, and people from all over the country have been reaching out, and we have taken in people from all over the country, and it has really grown. And we've been helping so many more people. And I think it's really exciting.
Debbi, you mentioned the Different Brains internship program. That sounds very exciting. Could you tell our viewers more about that?
Yeah, so our internship program, it started out, you know, where people would come into the office and they get to learn about video editing. They get to learn about, you know, webcasts, podcasts, and see if it was something that interested them and go on to finding a job in some of these fields, which is very important in this population because most of the people that come to us are what's called failure to launch, which is when they're kind of sitting home playing video games, their parents aren't sure what to do with them. So the parents are really the ones who reach out to us and say, hey, you know, I'm not sure what to do with my son or daughter at this point. You know, and so we have them come to us and we give them all these different things. You know, they write a blog, they talk about themselves. We get their anxiety levels down. We make them feel comfortable. You see the changes in them when they first come. They really aren't talking. They really aren't comfortable. And by the end, they're talking, they're comfortable, they're excited, they're, you know, getting in front of the camera talking. And it's just the amazing growth that happens from the beginning to the end. And so many of them have gone out to get jobs, and the parents come back to us and tell us how happy they are. And it's an exciting thing to see. And even in these coronavirus times now where depression is happening and, you know, so many of these people are sad and unhappy, we're 2 times a week meeting on the computer on Zoom calls. And like I said, kids from all over the country, and even they are starting out sad and, you know, not really talking. But within a few weeks, we have one group that meets on Tuesdays that, you know, we play games and it's more of a fun chat group. And then on Fridays, it's more of a business. And we talk about, you know, what we're doing in the different groups we have. And, you know, we have a fundraising group and a research group and, you know, an editing group. And so then we talk about business on Fridays, and that's more of a serious group. But we all talk about what we did for the week and how our week is going, and everybody gets a chance to talk. And then when a new person comes in, you have to introduce yourself and talk about yourself. So it gives everybody a chance to open up and talk and speak and be on camera. And they all, after a couple weeks, are more comfortable, and it's like a small family. And we have even now a speakers bureau where people are learning to give speeches. And you should see them flourish and give speeches, which they never thought they'd be able to do. And it's amazing, really amazing.
It certainly does sound amazing. So I'm not gonna let you stay with that, Debbi. How can our viewers find out about this program for themselves or their loved ones or their friends?
So they can first go to our website and take a look at it, which is differentbrains.org. And they can see all the different items that our interns produce. And secondly, they can email us at diffbrains.org, D-I-F-F. Brains, B-R-A-I-N-S, at gmail.com. autismcalstatespace.com.
Debbi, you've told us about your excellent training program for your internship. Debbi, you've told us about your excellent program getting the interns ready for employment. Can you tell our viewers a little bit more about what happens next? How do they actually get jobs, and what do you do to help them to get actual employment?
So what we do is, once they are at the end of their journey with us, we help them look at different employment programs that are in the area. So it used to be that they were just local for us. Now we're covering a much broader area. So this is all new to us. But we look at local places. So we have had, and I have to say, some people also go back to school. You know, we've had a lot of people go back to school, which is a big deal as well. Like, a lot of parents have wanted their kids to go back to school. They go back to school. We've also had some who work for Comcast. They are big in hiring down by us, which is a cable company. We have some that just get regular jobs, just at like a storage company, or at a or work for a family business, or start their own business. You know, everybody has their own journey, but we're just looking to help fill that gap right now. And then we have other people that we work with who kind of help them find their path. I think the digital media part is teaching them that this is the field they want to be in. And some want to be writers. Some want to be in the movie industry. We have someone who just made a documentary, and we're showing the film to different companies right now. So it's very interesting. Everyone is different, which is so exciting about it. But they're all going on their own journeys.
That's really good to hear. Like to take a slightly different direction now, a little bit more serious. Based on your experience with different brains, what seems to be the biggest challenge or challenges for the AS community in South Florida, and since you've been doing things digitally from around the country?
I definitely think what's been harder is, it's been harder on the families, a lot of job loss, a lot of things for the ASD community has to be paid out of pocket, which I think is very unfortunate. And we found that in my family as well. So there's not as much money to help these families. And it's a very sad situation right now. A lot of families were depending on, you know, getting more money from the government, and the government hasn't stepped up. A lot of people are losing money from disability money that they thought would be coming. A lot of people are applying for disability, which they never thought they had to. And it's not an easy thing to do when you're older. When you were younger, it was a little easier to do, and it's not easy to get. And they look for any reason to reject you, which is very sad. We have a lot of people right now with us who are telling us stories that are so sad. We also have places that, you know, that also work with you to help you get jobs through the government, and they make it so difficult at every turn. And it breaks my heart every time I hear a story like that. I mean, I just want to go there with them and explain their situation and say, how can you do this to them? Because I went through it with my brother, and I fought with my brother, you know, for everything with my brother. And I would just like to do it for everybody, because no matter how much, so many parents don't know everything, and they can't pay for the attorneys and the advocates and all these things. And it's just, it's a sad commentary on society right now.
How would you encourage the community to support the how would you encourage the city to support the autism community?
That is a good question. We do have a lot of good programs in our city in particular that are helping. We have a Chabad here that is that did this wonderful camp this summer, and they did it virtually, and they had people come in and they would drop off stuff to every kid's house, and so they could do the activities with the instructor. And I thought it was really amazing. They really stepped up, and we had Best Buddies who went virtual locally here. I don't know if they did that everywhere, but they definitely stepped up and did. But I wish more companies, more places were more accepting. And it's just sad that if you tell someone you have a disability, that they look at you differently, they feel differently, and they can't just say, okay, sign this application and, you know, here's a job. And you're looked at, if you have the same qualifications as the other person, why can't you be accepted just like they are? And you're probably a harder worker, and people just don't understand that part. And we need society to get that part. So I hope that answers your question.
No, very good answer. Keith, did you have a question?
Yeah, I think it's sort of my standard tying up one, which is basically which way forward, or what do you see happening, upcoming in new developments with different brains. Does that seem to work for you, Debbi?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right. So Debbi, what upcoming events, programs, achievements are likely to be happening at different brains over the next few to several months?
So for different brains, we've definitely switched more to a virtual model. So we're looking at first getting more edited programs for people that are working virtually and sending them to our young adults that are working from home. And so they can do their editing and working from their location. And that will help them be able to, you know, because a lot of people can't afford, you know, the editing programs and things like that. So we're looking at getting grants approved for that. We are also doing virtual events, and we're starting to plan monthly events online so that people can now see us from all over, which is very exciting for us because we were looking at doing them locally. And now that this virtual world has happened, we feel like we can reach more people, see more people. So we have our first speaker coming up next month, and we're excited about that. And we have a research group. We have a group of medical students that came in, and they're doing their first research paper with us, through us. So we have a lot of exciting things coming up.
So Debbi, you gave us a very good update on what are some new programs over the next several months for different brains. Going further and more broadly, what would you say, or where would you say the future lies for the autistic community in South Florida and around the country?
My hope is that acceptance is everywhere. My hope is that people with autism will be able to find jobs in big companies and not be questioned, not be looked at differently, and that it will just be a norm that you can just go in and be yourself and be accepted. and that will be the way life is from now on. And we can all live together peacefully and not frowned upon.
Well said.
Excellent. And as the old saying goes, from your lips to God's ears.
Yes, agreed.
Well, thank you very much, Debbi Siegel. You've been a wonderful guest. Very best of luck to you, your community, and all the folks at Different Brains. I know we had a great time talking with you, and hopefully we'll be talking with you again very soon. We'll now be hearing from Jennifer Brooks, our book correspondent.
Thank you, Keith. Today, I would like to tell you about an anthology titled What Every Autistic Girl Wishes Her Parents Knew. Here's the Japanese manga-inspired cover art that was done by a young woman named Haley Moss, who was one of the speakers at a recently concluded conference at Stanford focused on all aspects of neurodiversity, from K-12 education to employment to mental health issues, which included two speakers who are part of ASEND, Greg Yates on mental health and Mike Burnick on employment. And this anthology includes a selection by Haley Moss. It's gonna take me a minute to find it. Yeah, here we go. It's titled Perfect in an Imperfect World. It is not your or your daughter's job to set the world on fire, but to simply change perceptions one person at a time. Now, given the fact that there's almost 8 billion people in the world, that's gonna be a really slow process. And in a different selection, this is not Haley Moss, but a different contributor by the name of Jennifer St. Jude. And she was kind enough to put together a chart showing some of the most common characteristics that girls with autism tend to display, both positive and negative. Affectionate, that's definitely a positive. Belonging, well, as a young woman with autism myself, believe me, I know about belonging and about not belonging. And black and white, all or nothing thinking, which can be a good thing or a bad thing depending on the context. Creativity, difficulty seeing the big picture, just to name a few of the characteristics. So yes, especially if you're a parent of a young woman on the autism spectrum, or if you are a young woman on the autism spectrum, I encourage you to read this book, What Every Autistic Girl Wishes Her Parents Knew. Thank you.
Thank you, Jennifer. We'll now hear from Stacey Kennedy, our cultural correspondent.
Thank you, Keith. Okay, so Thursday, November 12th through Sunday, November 15th, there's going to be a virtual gala to share with the difference community members. And who is hosting this is ASAN, or Autistic Self-Advocacy Network. And there's going to be members and allies all across the country and all over the world. There's going to be Twitter chats, panels, and more. And events will be held, of course, online across a variety of platforms. And all times are in Eastern Standard Time. So depending on where you are, check your time zone. There's going to be different times for these different programs and panelists. So certainly go to autisticadvocacy.org. Friday, November 20th, Autistry Studios is also having a free online Zoom event. And they're gonna have a neurodiversity summit presented by UC Davis, Mind and Brain, and the Mind Institute. Thursdays, bi-weekly on Facebook Live, Dream Achievers Band usually has a live event and performance going on, usually at 12:30 p.m. Pacific time. And they have a message to say. They said, as we adjust to life in shelter in place, we hope to bring you music joy while we light it up blue and follow proper social distancing. And just one last thing, I'll make it quick. If you're a woman on the spectrum, the Autistic Women's Alliance may interest you. It's a Facebook group. They have a private group online, which, you know, sign up first and have them approve, they'll approve you first. And then there's a virtual coffee chat once a month or so. And this coming next Saturday, November 7th, at 1 p.m. Pacific, they will have a coffee chat. And one of their topics is either like, do you have a diagnosis or do you prefer self-diagnosis? Why or why not? How do you identify the autistic? Are you as autistic or not at all? So there'll be topics like that and questions like that. And
well, folks, that's this show for this week. I want to thank again our guest, Debbi Siegel of Different Brains. Until next time, I'm Keith Halperin.
I'm Will Burnick.
I'm Jennifer Brooks.
I'm Stacey Kennedy.
Debbi Siegel.
And we're Ascend, Life on the Autism Spectrum. Until next time, stay well and stay safe. Take care.